Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is a video to compare two fans from Corsair. The ML120 RGB Elite, seen here on the left in black, and the LL120, seen here on the right. Now, I've done a video previously comparing the LL120s with the QL120s, but the new ML120 RGB Elites are interesting and worth looking at. So in this video, I'm going to be talking to you about my experience with the two and showing off what they look like side by side, as well as talking about the differences between them. Now, samples of this video were taken from my recent video on the 5000T from Corsair, where it comes pre-installed with three white LL120s, and I swapped them out for the ML120 RGB Elites. Now, these are interesting fans for a number of different reasons. Firstly, they're a mix between essentially Corsair's ML120 fans and their Airguide Vortex style fans, meaning they're designed with these fins at the rear that you can see here, which allow for a better airflow and targeted airflow that's perfect for radiators and also for case use. The main difference immediately between the ML120 RGB Elites and the LL120s is aesthetics, essentially. The ML120s are designed for superior airflow, more on the specs in a minute, whereas the LL120s are designed to focus mainly on the looks. That's not to say they're bad for cooling, though, because I did use them in the Crystal 680X a long time ago, and they are very neat. Now, if you buy a triple pack of either of the fans, you do get a little RGB control box with inside, and you can see the ML120 RGB Elite one here. That essentially allows you to plug into six fans for the RGB connection, and then you just need to connect that USB cable and the SATA power cable. So the USB connects to your motherboard and the SATA to your PSU, and then that gives you power over the RGB lighting. Both fans have two cables, one for power and one for RGB. You can either plug the power cables directly into the motherboard or use something like the Commander Pro or the Commander Core XT as a fan control unit to then control the power for them. So you do need to connect up the two cables separately, and it does mean there are a lot of cables to deal with if you have a lot of these fans installed. You can see there are some visual aesthetic differences between them even when they're not powered on, though. For example, the ML120 RGB Elites look very nice from either side because they have that holographic sticker in the middle of them, which is present on both sides, whereas the LL120s, as I showed there, have a rather horrible looking sticker on the rear. However, obviously visually, the LL120s are superior because they have a lot more RGB lighting and the ring around the outside, whereas the RGB lighting on the ML120 RGB Elites is more focused on the fans. As I said, the ML120 RGB Elites is focused more on the performance. These are magnetic levitation fans, and they have a speed that goes from 450 to 2000 RPM. That's comparable with the LL120, which is hydraulic bearing instead of magnetic levitation, and those are 600 to 1500 RPM, so they don't spin as fast. The other thing that's interesting about the ML120s is because they're PWM controllable, they have a range from 0% up to 100%, which means that you can run them at 0 RPM, as you will see me doing here in the Corsair 5000T. So you can see that the fans aren't spinning, so they can be set so that they won't spin up unless it's required, meaning you can obviously have a very quiet case if your case isn't too toasty. This is obviously fantastic. Now, in terms of the airflow, the ML120 RGB Elites obviously offer a better potential airflow as well. You can get up to 58.10 CFM from it, and they have a better static pressure up to 2.9 millimeters. And I will include all the specifications in the description, but essentially what I'm saying is that on paper and in practice, the ML120 RGB Elites offer superior cooling and also the potential for running at 0 RPM, meaning they just don't spin when not required, as long as you have the right setup. You can see some of the RGB lighting here. Obviously, that Vortex Airguide fin setup on the back does mean that the back side of them potentially doesn't look quite as nice, but it does also mean that you do get fantastic guided airflow through radiators and throughout the case. Now, The fans, obviously, aesthetically are quite different. The LL120s, you can obviously see the RGB lighting ring around the front. And at the rear, that just has 4 points. And then obviously that central area as well, which unfortunately just has that little sticker on it. And it's not quite as fancy. They both have anti-vibration mounts on them. And they are designed to deliver cool and quiet performance. There is a decibel difference in them as well, that's worth noting. The LL120s go up to 24.8 decibels, whereas the ML120s can go between 10 and 30 decibels. So they're potentially louder, but they do spin faster at the top end. So you can get up to 2000 RPM instead of 1500. So it's not surprising they are louder. However, my experience with the ML120 RGB Elites is in setup with a lot of fans in the case. So you can see there's 10 fans set up in this case. And yet I did some tests where I ramped up those fans to their most extreme speed. So every fan set to maximum. And then I used a decibel meter to register the loudness of it. And it was coming out around 56 decibels. And what I found is that is not obnoxious. And it's not anywhere near as loud as you might think. I've had some experience previously with other fans from Corsair, like QL120s, which I found to be a bit louder than this, and these Elite fans are excellent in terms of cooling and overall performance. However, obviously they're not as nice looking as the LL120s, and if you want a focus on RGB, then the QL120s are even more impressive. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.